Hello and welcome to the most awaited FTR 3.0 by competition community, especially for English medium students. My name is Pokhraj Giri, and in this FTR session, I'll be dealing with Chhattisgarh General Studies. And this video of the FTR is all about the modern history of Chhattisgarh. And this is the second part of this modern history, in which I have covered the events between 1854 and 1947. However, let me tell you, there will be a special part 3 which will actually comprise of tribal revolts in Chhattisgarh, peasant movements in Chhattisgarh, labor movements in Chhattisgarh, and other miscellaneous stuff. So let us start with this video. However, before starting, there is a special announcement that we at Competition Community are organizing weekly test, which will be held on every Sunday at 11 a.m. So what you people have to do, you people have to actually enroll yourselves by Friday evening so that you people can write the test on Sunday. So this was all about the announcement, and let's move to the questions. And here we have our first question. So in the first question, it says, who had started the magazine Suryoday? And what are the options that we have? We have Dr. Kanhaiya Lal Sharma. We have Pandit Lochan Prasad Pandey. We have Madhav Rao Sapre. And we have Vaman Rao Lakhe. Now talking about journalism in general in Chhattisgarh. So let me tell you, Madhav Rao Sapre is known as father of journalism in Chhattisgarh. Now there are two famous newsletters which were actually started by him. First was Chhattisgarh Mitra, which he started in the year 1900 from Pendra Road, now in the Gorilla Pendra Marwahi district of Chhattisgarh. And the second was Hind Kesari in the year 1907. Now regarding Chhattisgarh Mitra, I'll tell you that he himself was actually the editor of Chhattisgarh Mitra. His joint editor was Ram Rao Chincholkar, and the publisher was Vaman Rao Lakhe. This Chhattisgarh Mitra was actually a monthly newsletter, and it is also considered to be the first newsletter of Chhattisgarh. However, this newsletter was discontinued in the year 1903 because of lack of funds. Now about Hind Kesari, Madhav Rao Sapre ji actually started this Hind Kesari in 1907 from Nagpur, and Jagannath Prasad Shukla and Lakshmidhar Vajpayee were two people who had actually helped him in the publishing of this Hind Kesari. Let me also tell you that in the year 1908, Pandit Madhav Rao Sapre was actually arrested because of this newsletter Hind Kesari, and a case was registered against him. However, because of his family pressure, he would actually issue an apology to the Britishers, and then the case was taken back. So this was all about Madhav Rao Sapre ji, who is known to be the father of journalism in Chhattisgarh. And we also got a miscellaneous fact about Vaman Rao Lakhe ji, that he was actually the publisher of this Chhattisgarh Mitra. regarding Pandit Lochan Prasad Pandey, I'll tell you, he was the famous writer and the historian who in the year 1914, that is 1914, wrote Mewad Gatha. And this Mewad Gatha was actually aimed at spreading nationalism. And finally, we have Dr. Kanhaiya Lal Sharma. So this Suryoday was actually a handwritten magazine, which was published from Raipur in the year 1915 by Dr. Kanhaiya Lal Sharma. So, who had started the magazine Suryoday? So, magazine Suryoday was actually a handwritten magazine which was published from Raipur in the year 1915 by Dr. Kanhaiya Lal Sharma. However, after some time, this Suryoday was actually renamed as Vidyoday. So it was renamed as Vidyoday. So what is going to be the correct option for this question number one? Option A, Dr. Kanhaiya Lal Sharma, is going to be the correct option for this question number one. Now we have a second question. Consider the following statements. We have the first statement, Political Conference of Regional Congress was held at Raipur in 1907. In the second statement, we have it was presided over by Shri Kelkar. And in the third statement, we have it resulted in a split in Congress into moderates and extremists in Chhattisgarh. And what we have to do, we have to actually choose the correct statements. Now, let me tell you a brief background related to this question. So it was in the year 1907 that the yearly session of Congress was held at Surat in Gujarat. And Pandit Sundarlal Sharma from Chhattisgarh actually happened to attend this Surat session. Now, this Surat session actually happened to witness the famous split in Congress between the extremists and moderates. Now in Chhattisgarh as well, the regional Congress comprised of both kinds of people. By both kinds, I mean to say people with extremist thinking and people with moderate thinking. Among the extremists were Pandit Ravi Shankar Shukla, then Dada Saheb Khaparde, then Madhav Rao Sapre, then Vaman Rao Lakhe, then Barrister Chedilal, then was E. Raghavendra Rao. Apart from them, Thakur Hanuman Singh and Lakshman Rao Uday Girkar were the leaders in the regional Congress who were actually of the extremist thinking. Now, about the moderates, Shri Kelkar, Hari Singh Gaur, Dr. Munje and C.A. Thakkar were among some of the prominent leaders of Chhattisgarh with the moderate thinking. So what exactly happens? It was on 29th of March 1907 when a political conference of the regional congress was actually organized at town hall at Raipur. And this political conference was actually to be presided over by Shri Kelkar. However, Dada Sahib Khaparde, who was of this extremist thinking, he actually put forward a request that this regional session should actually start only after singing Vande Mataram. However, Hari Singh Gaur and Dr. Munje were actually opposed to this. However, later on, the session did start only after singing Vande Mataram, but this historical political conference of regional congress did see the split in the regional congress into the moderates and extremists. So actually, I should say, the political conference of regional congress in Raipur also did see the split in the regional congress into the extremists and the moderates. Now let us consider these statements. First statement says, political conference of regional congress was held at Raipur in 1907. Yes, we have seen it is true. Second statement says, it was presided over by Shri Kelkar. We have seen that this second statement is also true. And the third statement says, it resulted in a split in congress into moderates and extremists in Chhattisgarh. We have seen that this statement is also correct. So, we have to choose the correct statements. So, all of these statements 1, 2 and 3 are correct. So, we will choose an option which says 1, 2 and 3. And in the option number C, we have this 1, 2, 3. And hence, option C is going to be the correct option for this question number 2nd. So, this was all about question number 2. Next, we have a third question. Raipur branch of Home Rule League was established by. So, let me tell you, there were actually two Home Rule Leagues. One was known as Home Rule League, which was actually started by Annie Besant. And the second was All India Home Rule League, which was actually headed by Bal Gangadhar Tilak. So this All India Home Rule League had its branches in Chhattisgarh. Now let's look at this question with the help of a map. So first of all, in this Bilaspur district of Chhattisgarh, the famous leaders associated with All India Home Rule League were Gajadhar Sao, then Kunj Bihari Agnihotri, then Govind Prasad Tiwari. So Gajadhar Sao, Kunj Bihari Agnihotri and Govind Prasad Tiwari were the leaders associated with the All India Home Rule League from this Bilaspur district. From this Rajnandgaon district, the branch of All India Home Rule League was actually established by Thakur Pyarelal Singh. Now, in this Durg district of Chhattisgarh, the branch of All India Home Rule League was established by Ghan Shyam सिंह गुप्त आर्म्ड एट रायपुर The branch of All India Home Rule League was established by Pandit Ravi Shankar Shukla. So coming back to the question, the Raipur branch of the Home Rule League was actually established by Pandit Ravi Shankar Shukla. So the Raipur branch was established by Pandit Ravi Shankar Shukla. This is what we have seen in the question number 3. Now we have question number 4, which actually says choose the false statements related to the non-cooperation movement in Chhattisgarh. Now let me tell you, there were certain activities which were actually performed during this non-cooperation movement in Chhattisgarh. The first among the activities was giving up the titles. So let me tell you, first was the title of Rai Sahab, and this title was actually given up by Vaman Rao Lakhe. However, he was later conferred with the title of Lokpriya by the people. Apart from Vaman Rao Lakhe, Barrister Kalyanji, Morarji Thekar and Seth Gopi Kishan also gave away the titles of Rai Sahab. The next title was Khan Sahab, which was actually given up by Qazi Sham Sher Khan. And the third title was Rai Bahadur. And this title was actually given up by Nagendra Nath Day. So in the first statement itself, we have Barrister Nagendra Nath Day gave up the title Rai Bahadur. So this statement, according to the explanation, is going to be correct. Now the next activity was giving up advocacy. So from Raipur, Ram Narayan Tiwari Yadav Rao Deshmukh Pandit Ravi Shankar Shukla gave up advocacy. From Bilaspur, Barrister Chedilal E. Raghavendra Rao and Vaman Rao Khan Khoje gave up advocacy. From Durg, Ghan Shyam Singh Gupt gave up advocacy. From Rajnath Gaonwar, Thakur Pyarelal Singh and Baldev Prasad Mishra. TPS Thakur Pyarelal Singh, BPM Baldev Prasad Mishra. And from Chui Khadan Princely Estate, Govardhan Lal Srivastav gave up advocacy. So this Govardhan Lal Srivastav gave up advocacy from the Chui Khadan estate. And hence, according to this explanation, statement number 2 is also correct. Now in the statement number 3, we have पंडित रविशंकर शुक्ल प्लेड एन इंपॉर्टेंट रोल इन द ओपनिंग ऑफ नेशनल स्कूल्स. सो थर्ड इंपॉर्टेंट एक्टिविटी रिलेटेड टू दिस नॉन कॉपरेशन मूवमेंट वॉज ओपनिंग अप ऑफ नेशनल स्कूल्स. एंड लेट मी टेल यू, माधव राव सप्रे हैड प्लेड एन इंस्ट्रूमेंटल रोल इन ओपनिंग दीज नेशनल स्कूल्स, बट इन द स्टेटमेंट पंडित रविशंकर शुक्ल इज गिवन इंस्टेड ऑफ माधव राव सप्रे, एंड हेंस दिस स्टेटमेंट 3 इज गोइंग टू बी इनकरेक्ट. नाउ द नेक्स्ट इंपॉर्टेंट एक्टिविटी वॉज रिजाइनिंग फ्रॉम द गवर्नमेंट जॉब्स एंड फ्रॉम बिलासपुर यदुनंदन प्रसाद श्रीवास्तव एंड शिवलाल वर्मा रिजाइंड फ्रॉम द गवर्नमेंट जॉब्स फ्रॉम बिलासपुर. सो एक्चुअली दिस स्टेटमेंट 4 अकॉर्डिंग टू द एक्सप्लेनेशन इज करेक्ट. Now what we have to tell, which of the statements are false. So we have seen only statement number 3 is false. So we have to select an option which actually says only statement 3 is false. And in this option C, we have an option which says only 3 is false, and hence option C is going to be the correct option for this question number 4. So this was all about question number 4. Now next we have the 5th question, and it says the leaders of Chhattisgarh who attended the Belgaum session of Congress 1924 were. Now let me tell you, this Belgaum session of Congress, which was held in the year 1924, was very very important because it was the only session of Congress which was actually presided over by Mahatma Gandhi, and Pandit Sundarlal Sharma, Nathuji Jagtap and Lakshmi Narayan Das. These were the 3 people from Chhattisgarh who had actually attended this Belgaum session of Congress. So, what are the correct ones? Pandit Sundarlal Sharma, then Nathuji Jagtap, and then Lakshmi Narayan Das. So, we have to select an option which says 1, 2, 3, and here in the option A itself, we have 1, 2, 3, and hence option A is going to be the correct option of this question number 5. Next, we have our 6th question. So, the 6th question says, which of the following statements are true with reference to the civil disobedience movement in Chhattisgarh? So, let me tell you. The civil disobedience movement in Chhattisgarh started with breaking of salt law. And this salt law was actually broken at Raipur by Pandit Ravi Shankar Shukla. While at Dhamtari, it was broken by Narayan Rao Megha. So the first statement says salt law at Dhamtari was broken by Narayan Rao Megha Wale, and by the explanation now we know that it was certainly broken by Narayan Rao Megha Wale at Dhamtari. So the first statement is correct. The second statement says 13th April 1930, Jawaharlal Nehru visited Chhattisgarh. So let me tell you, on the 13th of April 1930, meeting of the political council was actually held at Raipur. And Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru was to visit Chhattisgarh to attend this meeting. However, he could not because he was arrested. But in the statement says that he visited Chhattisgarh, and hence the statement is incorrect because he was to visit Chhattisgarh but he was unable because he was arrested. Next, the third statement says 8th August 1930 Kranti Kumar Bharti hoisted tricolor at Bilaspur Town Hall. So let me tell you, actually a meeting was organized in the town hall under the chairmanship of Barrister Chedilal. And a decision was made that the tricolor would be hoisted at the town hall. And finally, it was on the 8th of August 1930 that Kranti Kumar Bharti did keep the promise and he hoisted the tricolor at the Bilaspur town hall. So this statement is going to be correct. However, Kranti Kumar Bharti ji did later also hoist tricolor at the government high school also. And for this, he was sentenced to 6 months of imprisonment. So we have seen third statement is also correct. So we have seen statement 1 and 3 are correct while statement number 2 is incorrect. So we have to tell which of the statements are true. So statement 1 and statement 3 are correct ones or the true ones. So we have to select an option which says 1 and 3 and in the option number C we have this 1 and 3 and hence option C is going to be the correct option for this question number 6. Now let's move to the 7th question. Now in the 7th question we have marked the columns and these are related to actually Quit India movement of the year 1942. So, in the first column, we have activities as in procession against the arrest of Gandhiji at Raipur. Second is hoisting the tricolor at Nagpur High Court. Third is Durg Court arson and fourth is Raipur conspiracy case. And in the leaders column, we have Raghunandan Singh Rawal, Ranveer Singh Shastri, Ram Krishna Singh and we have Parasram Soni. So, let me tell you. It was only after the arrest of Mahatma Gandhi that a huge procession was organized at Raipur against the arrest of Gandhiji. And this procession was actually led by Ranveer Singh Shastri. Now let me also tell you, Thakur Ram Krishna Singh, he hoisted the tricolor at the Nagpur High Court. And in regard to this Quit India movement of 1942, on 28th of August, Raghunandan Singh Rawal actually put the Durg High Court into flames. And this event or incident is known as Durg Court arson. And in the year 1942, the leader of this Raipur conspiracy case was Parasram Soni. This Raipur conspiracy case was actually aimed at making explosives and cartridges and other weapons. So in forming pairs, we have A2. Then we have B3. Then we have C1 and D4. So we have A2, B3, C1 and D4. Looking at the options, in the option number D, we have this A2, B3, C1 and D4. And hence, this option D is going to be the correct option for this question number 7. So this was all about the 7th question. Now next, we have the 8th question. And in the 8th question, what we have to do? We have to arrange the following events as per the timeline in the increasing order. So this Sihava Nagri Jungle Satyagraha was held in conjunction with the non-cooperation movement in the year 1922. The Siksha Mandir Yojana was actually brought forward in the year 1937 by Dadan, Education Minister of Central Province and Berar, Pandit Ravi Shankar Shukla. Vanar Sena was actually formed in the year 1932 in conjunction with the second phase of civil disobedience movement. And this Raipur dynamite case, it occurred in conjunction with the Quit India movement in the year 1942. So, what is going to be the correct sequence? The first one was Sihava Nagri Jungle Satyagraha. The second one is formation of Vanar Sena. The third one is Siksha Mandir Yojana. And the fourth one is Raipur Dynamite case. So what is going to be the correct sequence? The correct sequence is 1, 2, 3 and 4. And we have this 1, 2, 3, 4 in the option number A. Hence, this option A is going to be the correct option for this question number 8. So this was all about the 8th question. Now we have a 9th question. In conjunction with the second phase of civil disobedience movement, who led the movement held in the Raigarh Riyasat? So let me tell you, in conjunction with this second phase of civil disobedience movement, a movement was started in the Raigarh Riyasat. And this movement was actually led by a local nationalist by the name of Amarnath Tiwari. So option number A, Amarnath Tiwari, is going to be the correct option for this question number 9. And finally, we have our 10th and the last question. So in the 10th question, we have the leaders of Chhattisgarh who were not arrested under the Operation Zero Hour were. So after the declaration of Quit India Movement in the year 1942, this Operation Zero Hour was actually launched by the British government to not only arrest Gandhiji, but also the other major leaders of Congress. And the leaders from Chhattisgarh, while returning from this Bombay session from where this Quit India Movement was declared, they were actually arrested at the Malkanpur station in the boundary of the central province. And the major leaders that were arrested were Pandit Ravi Shankar Shukla, Barrister Chedilal, then Khub Chand Baghel, Lakshmi Narayan Das, Y.V. Tamaskar, Kunj Bihari Agnihotri, then were Dwarika Prasad Mishra, then Shiv Das Daga, Ram Gopal Tiwari and Ghan Shyam Singh Gupt. So these were the major leaders of Chhattisgarh who were actually arrested under the Operation Zero Hour. So what are the names that we have? We have Thakur Pyare Lal Singh, we have Lakshman Rao Udaygirkar, we have Vaman Rao Lakhe and we have Shivdas Daga. So out of them, we have actually already seen that Shivdas Daga was arrested. Hence, fourth name will not be correct in reference to this question. So out of the ones that are given, we have not seen Thakur Pyare Lal Singh, we have not seen Lakshman Rao Udaygirkar and we have not seen Vaman Rao Lakhe. So these were the leaders, I should say, which were actually not arrested under this Operation Zero Hour. So the not arrested ones were 1, 2 and 3. 1 as in Thakur Pyare Lal, 2 as in Vaman Rao Lakhe and 3 as in Lakshman Rao Udaygirkar. So what we have to do, we have to choose an option which actually says 1, 2 and 3, and here in the option number A we have this 1, 2, 3. So option A is going to be the correct option for this 10th question. So these were some of the most conceptual and important questions from the modern history part 2 of Chhattisgarh. I'll be back in the next video with the third part of this modern history of Chhattisgarh. I hope you people would have liked my video and I shall meet you people in my coming videos. Tab tak le, thank you and take care.
CGPSC की संपूर्ण तैयारी के लिए कंपटीशन कम्युनिटी के YouTube चैनल को सब्सक्राइब कीजिए और डेली अपडेट्स के लिए बेल आइकन को प्रेस करना ना भूलें।